Most of us know Ozzy Osbourne as a musician and the lead singer of Black Sabbath and his solo career. But did you know he also had a few notable movie roles? So in today's video, I'm going to be focusing on two of them, which will be Trick or Treat from 1986 and Little Nicky from the year 2000. This video was requested by a channel member whose first name is Bronson. So if you did not know, my channel has memberships open and all members can make requests for video topics. And this is actually my first request that I'm doing, so I thought it would be a pretty fun topic. I did this video many years ago, but now my YouTube and editing skills are a lot better. I think it's a good video and it was requested. I'm also going to talk about the movie soundtracks for both movies, and I'll throw in some trivia along the way. Let's start with Trick or Treat. This is a movie that came out in 1986. It was maybe one of the first horror movies that centered around heavy metal. It's classified as a horror movie or a comedy musical. It was directed by Charles Martin Smith, which is his directorial debut, and produced by the De Laurentiis Entertainment Group. The movie stars Mark Price and Tony Fields and has special appearances by both Gene Simmons and Ozzy Osbourne. The movie is about a metalhead teenager who becomes haunted by the ghost of his rock hero. That's basically the gist of the story. The movie got mixed reviews, but later developed a cult following. The cameo from Ozzy Osbourne appears right in the beginning of the film. It's a very short scene. It shows a woman doing some type of aerobics in a room, and Ozzy Osbourne is on television that's on the nightstand. It's some type of news interview. Ozzy Osbourne plays a reverend, talking about explicit lyrics and music. Ozzy looks very different. He has short hair. He's dressed in a white shirt and a tie. So he was made to look and act completely different than he is in real life. So here's some interesting trivia with this movie. It was taken from an interview with Mark Price back in 1986. According to Mark Price, after Trick or Treat was filmed, one of Ozzy's fans had tickets to go to one of his concerts in Michigan, but he couldn't go to the concert because he was very sick. So Mark Price asked Ozzy through his wife Sharon to sign and send an autographed picture to the fan. Mark gave his fans address to Ozzy and Sharon, so they could send him the autographed picture, but instead, Ozzy and Sharon both showed up at the fan's house right before the concert. The story shows that Ozzy can be a really good guy. Now, the movie has a soundtrack, but the soundtrack wasn't a compilation album like most soundtracks. It was actually a studio album by the heavy metal band Fastway. It was their fourth album called Trick or Treat. So it was both a studio album and a movie soundtrack. So if you didn't know, the band Fastway was formed by Motorhead guitarist Fast Eddie Clark, and the album has Dave King on vocals, which was his last album with Fastway. The movie soundtrack was pretty straightforward heavy metal. I think the sound of it reminded me a lot of the band Wasp, although I would say most Wasp albums were better than this. The album is pretty standard heavy metal, lots of songs with distorted power chords and big vocal choruses. There was one power ballad at the end of the album, but otherwise it was just a typical heavy metal album of the 80s. I wouldn't say it had any songs that stood out, but very representative for the music at that time. Next, I want to talk about Little Nicky. It's a comedy movie that came out in the year 2000. It's an Adam Sandler movie, and it actually didn't do very well. It got negative reviews from critics, and it bombed at the box office, so it actually lost money when it first came out. The movie has a pretty big cast. It features Adam Sandler as Nicky, who is the son of Satan and an angel named Holly. Also has Patricia Arquette as his love interest. Harvey Keitel plays Satan. Rodney Dangerfield plays Lucifer, who was the grandfather, and this was his second to last movie role before he passed away. And Reese Witherspoon plays Holly, who is Nicky's mother, who was an angel. There's one scene in the movie where Nicky wakes up in heaven and he meets his mother, Holly, and who is an angel. She tells him he can use this inner light that he was born with to fight against his brother, Adrian, who was more of like the evil brother. And she gives him this mysterious orb, and then Nicky confronts Adrian in Central Park. But then Adrian transforms into a bat and locks Nicky into a flask, and then Nicky escapes the flask. But then he summons Ozzy Osbourne to appear to bite off Adrian's head, and he spits it back into the flask. So in summary, Ozzy Osbourne plays himself, and he is summoned to bite the head off of a bat who is actually Adam Sandler's brother in the movie played by Rhys Ifans, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. There's also a scene where you can see Ozzy Osbourne's photo from the Trick or Treat movie on the wall in Little Nicky's room, and that's a little bit of trivia right there. Now, before I finish the video, I want to talk about the soundtrack for Little Nicky. This came out in 2000, And the soundtrack is basically a nu metal compilation. It's pretty much what it is. So, for example, there are two songs by the Deftones. They have Change in the House of Flies. There's an acoustic version of Be Quiet and Drive. So those were pretty good songs. There's one Linkin Park song, which is Points of Authority. One Disturbed song called Stupefy, which is a special remix for that movie. There's Part of Me by Incubus. Rockstar by Cypress Hill. When Worlds Collide by Powerman 5000. Cave by Muse. Then it was the song Take a Picture by Filter. And here's a little funny side note, because not long ago I was listening to the radio and the song came on and I'm listening to it. I'm thinking, like, I know the song, like, what is it? And then it wasn't until actually, like, before preparing this video that I realized it was that Filter song that I was thinking of, which was on the radio, which is called Take a Picture. I know it's kind of a weird story, but anyway, let me continue. There was also School of Hard Knocks by POD. And two bands I didn't recognize. One song was called Natural High by a band called Insolence, which was kind of a funky nu metal band, kind of like the Red Hot Chili Peppers, but they were more industrial. And another one was a band called Unloco. The song was called Nothing, which sounds like a typical nu metal band, but they were trying to sound like Korn. So as you can see, a pretty varied nu metal compilation album. So that is all. As you can see, this was requested by a channel member. So if you want to become a channel member, you can make requests like this, only $2.99 a month. I'm only putting up one tier, and in addition to video requests, you get early access to my videos, sometimes 2 or 3 days in advance. So that's another perk. So if you're interested in my original video I did on this topic, I'll stick that right here. It's an older video, but includes some other movies in as well, as such as Trolls, and I think there were a few more other ones. So please give this video a like. It helps me with the YouTube algorithm. Please subscribe if you have not already. I do rock and metal reviews. I do tier lists, classic album reviews, and I'll see you in the next one.